built a product, you believe in it, and now the question is, how do you actually get people to notice it? How do you go to market? It's a question that every entrepreneur has to face at the beginning of their journey, and we are going to answer that question here in a really unique way. My name is Jason Pfeiffer. I'm the editor-in-chief of Entrepreneur Magazine, and I have brought together an entrepreneur who is at this point in his journey and an expert, a venture capitalist, can help him think through what his first steps should be. So I'm going to introduce both, and then we are going to have a conversation where you can watch live as this entrepreneur gets his go-to-market strategy ready. First, the expert, Jesse Draper, founding partner at Halogen Ventures. Jesse, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
And our entrepreneur, also named Jesse, Jesse Forte, who has an oral care line that he's been working on. Jesse, start us off. Tell us how you got into the oral care business and where you are right now, ready to go.
As a kid, I got in a car accident. I was 10 years old, and our family didn't have the insurance to get my tooth fixed the correct way. And so ever since I was about 10 years old, I was always very just specific about my teeth. I was very, you know, emotional about it. And I never really wanted anybody to go through that type of situation. And so I always wondered, how could I get into the oral care hygiene line without being a dentist? How could I do something innovative to help out other people that may be in the same issue that I am? And so about a year ago, I got a bunch of products like charcoal and these little baking soda things that, you know, I put together and I started mixing, I started mastering, I started putting different toothpaste together and having my friends try them out. And before you knew it, I had a product that a lot of people really enjoyed. And so I thought to myself, what could I pair this with that's natural, that's organic, that would support long life? And so I did a lot of research on toothbrushes and toothpaste and bamboo and different roots that, you know, humans use through the evolution of anthropology. And one that really stuck out with me was the Mishwak stick. This stick is unlike anything that has really come out in the sense that it's anti-carcinogenic, which means that it fights against cancer. It kills bad breath. It makes your teeth whiter, you know, and on top of that, it's biodegradable.
Jesse, that's an awesome story. I know you have developed something of a marketing strategy already that you haven't executed yet, so we're going to talk about that. But first, Jesse Draper, I want to ask you, as you hear that, I bet that the first thing you're thinking about is simply, this is an extremely crowded market, and so getting attention for a new brand in a marketplace like this has to be difficult, right?
Definitely. I mean, it is a very busy space. We invest in consumer businesses, and I'm very familiar with the oral care space, and it is very busy, but that doesn't mean you should be discouraged from getting in there. It sounds like you have some real unique draws. One, you have this very authentic story as to why oral care is so important to you. And it sounds like it stands for biodegradability. It sounds like, you know, you weren't able to afford the care you needed. And so I would assume this needs to be affordable, which also makes it competitive in the market. And then, you know, you're creating a better product overall. And so I think your story will speak to the world. And so you just want to continue to kind of like tie that into the marketing, I would say.
I'm not looking to be the next Colgate. What I'm looking to do is being someone that moms and fathers can trust. When customers get our supply, you know, there'll be weekly check-ins. Hey, what did this flavor taste like? How do your teeth feel? Have you noticed anything different? What would you recommend? Not only are we providing a product, but we're looking after the people that actually take our product, and we're making them better.
I think what you're doing is fantastic. And something else that you clearly stand for is the fact that this stick fights cancer. You know, like that is your entry point into the market. Like you have something different and unique that can bring customers on board. And, you know, then you can get them to convert to the toothpaste and so many other things.
All right. So what I'm hearing is great product, differentiated in the marketplace, but how do you actually get attention for that? And how do you convince people that you're worth trusting over some brands that they already know? Jesse, what's a good first step in getting that word out there?
So we live in a world of online marketing these days. And honestly, I think it's become very expensive to buy these ads. So when you're just starting out and you don't have a lot of money to spend on marketing, just start simply by creating your email list and a very simple newsletter that you can start blasting out to your customers. And then, you know, start your social media and start telling part of your story within your social media, and people will become more and more familiar with your brand. Figure out how to get your first 1,000 customers and then go talk to them and figure out who they are and what they represent and what they care about and why they're interested in your toothpaste. And that will really set you up for success in terms of growing your customer base. You know, you can do something very simple on your website where you collect email addresses first before they even are able to enter your website and buy anything. I think that's very important in the beginning. Also to offer any kind of referral code or, hey, buy one, get one free, give it to a friend. You know, I think anything like that, people love a good deal. And you just want to get your product in people's hands right now.
Speaking of marketing plans as an artist, you know, my song just went number one on iTunes, Make It Happen. And I started making music about 8 months ago. I went from zero listeners to over 3.7 million in 8 months. And, you know, being a street performer, you know, bringing a boombox and a mic on the subway and performing for tips, you know, 4 years ago to now actually seeing true numbers, you know, pop up has been an honor. It's humbled me. It's been one of my favorite things. My clients, my customers are also fans of my music. And I want my fans and I want the people that listen to me, not only do I want their minds to be filled with great, you know, information, but I want their bodies and their mouths to feel good. And so if I can tap into their brain with my music, with my books, I'd also like to, you know, provide a product that's going to help them.
I think this is brilliant because you know, we hadn't even gotten to the idea of influencers, and it sounds like you already are an influencer. You're a musician, you've written quite a few books, so I'm sure you have some sort of following, which gives you really a leg up in terms of getting this product out there. Plus, I love the idea of when you're performing at concerts, instead of selling merch, you're like, no, you should have clean teeth, and this is my toothpaste brand. And I think it makes you very, very unique. And I think that's a great marketing hook overall. You know, it's like millennials and Gen Z care more about where everything came from. Is it biodegradable? And they care about who makes the product that they're buying more than any other generations.
Jesse Draper, I want to ask you, you're responding really well to Jesse Forte's ability to get himself out there in the world, tell his story, get people to be attracted to his message. But it reminds me of something that you had said earlier about how you build that newsletter, you build a social media presence, and then you want to lean into your own story. But I had wondered, for the average person who maybe isn't putting music out or isn't performing in front of people, they may have a story to tell, but they're also wondering, who's going to listen to my story? So how do you actually get people to engage with your story from, you know, a cold start?
Campaigns are a really fantastic way to get out there. You know, we've all seen a viral campaign from the ice bucket challenge to all your favorite products launching different types of giveaways. Think about what's authentic to your product. In this case, we're talking about oral care. Is there something around the mouth or teeth or smile that we can create a great hashtag and get it out there? I mean, marketing can really be affordable these days because you create a hashtag, you create your own email list, you just slowly grow. And, you know, I want to bring it back to those 1,000 core customers, those first customers. Those become your ambassadors. You want to keep them happy. You want to stay in touch with them. You want to offer them special discounts, giveaways, free product, and they will start becoming these ambassadors for you just because they love your product, they love your story, and they feel like they were there first supporting you because they believed in this product and idea overall. You can actually organically, kind of in a grassroots style, create this little army of ambassadors of your brand. And that is what I would recommend. Another thing you can actually do, because you do have some social following, is do some tests with your audience and just kind of say, hey, if you were creating a toothpaste brand, what would be important to you? Or what are your favorite oral care brands? Or what do you do? What's your daily routine in terms of cleaning your teeth? And just kind of see what people say, because you'll start hearing the same things over and over. And those are the pieces of information you should listen to for your brand, because there's something important in there that will help you build your brand in a stronger way within your community. And so I would really think about just your core audience.
Jesse Forte, I just wanted to ask you, because you are out there, you are engaging with people in a lot of different ways right now. Have you set up some mechanism by which you're surveying them or trying to get some feedback about what it is that they like? And how difficult do you think it's going to be to try to transition those people who know you for one thing? Because I think this is something that people struggle with. Maybe they're known in one arena and they're trying to start a company in a completely different one. And they're wondering, how do I transition people who know me as something over here to people who know me over there? Have you started those kinds of conversations? Are you soliciting that kind of feedback from people? And how's it going?
So if music's taught me anything about entrepreneurship, it's that I'm in this for the long haul. I may not see anything for the next year or two. I gave friends, gifts, with the Flawless Forte package last year and during Christmas and now, and I'm getting a lot of feedback, because what I want to do is get to know my customers, is really build an authentic, organic brand that people enjoy, they talk about.
So what are you doing in terms of email marketing and newsletters and targeting your customers?
Right now, I'm building the email list. A lot of my contacts are music industry, are part of the Young Revolutionary Minds, society that I created. What's special about what I'm about to do is that I'm looking at a subscription base for this process. Hmm. People that purchase my product, whether it's, $7 a month, they'll be getting, shipped in product, every 5 to 6 weeks, with reviews. What did you think about this? Was this enough toothpaste? Mm-hmm. Did you like this flavor? What flavors do you have in mind? Kind of like how you're talking about, getting those questions out there so I can get the feedback.
So Jesse Forte, you just described knowing a lot of, you've met a lot of people who have some influence, and then also you just have fans who just know your stuff. And now you've got Jesse who's talking about the importance of the thousand true fans, as it's called. And I've always wondered, and so Jesse Draper, I'm hoping you can shed some light here. I've always wondered, so you've got these people, what's the ask that you make of them? Do you ask them to tell other people about my newsletter, or here, I wrote something, share it with them, hoping that it's going to become something of a lead magnet? Do you ask them to just evangelize your product to whoever they see? What is it that you are supposed to do to ask those people to activate themselves?
I'd say the simplest thing you can do is say, hey, here's some toothpaste. I want you to test the project and get their email address, and then follow up with them and say, hey, what did you think of the toothpaste? And start collecting feedback that way. And you can tell them when you initially, come up with some draw where it's like, if you give me your email address, I'll just send you a quick survey. And if you fill it out, I'll send some free toothpaste to your friend. And then you get another email address and another address. And there's so many ways that you can kind of like become a little more viral. Something else I was thinking about for you that might be interesting, because you have such a great story. I was thinking about like this cancer stick idea. That's what I'm calling it now, because I think it's great that you're using this stick that apparently fights cancer. Also because of the biodegradability, you could choose a charity, nonprofit organization, and actually give back in some way, where every time someone buys a subscription, you send a free toothpaste or stick to one of these organizations. And some people look at that as losing out on revenue, but you're not losing out on revenue if you look at it as a marketing spend. You're actually bringing this incredible organization along for the ride. You're supporting an organization with authentic people who could become your customers. And it's actually a great way to get a hold of a larger email list while you're doing something good.
You're so right. And I don't like to get too far ahead of myself. I really wanted to focus in on the marketing and the budget and the subscription aspect of this. And what I want to say is that this stick is going to be very supportive for people who are on the streets. So right now, I want to generate revenue so that we can stay in business, so that we can survive, so that we can thrive. But later on, like, my whole purpose is to give back.
I love that. And it sounds like there's an organization in there somewhere that is so authentic to you and helped you out during some of those rough nights in New York or what have you, that you can give back to and team up with and make a significant change. And it was something that you, you know, helped with previously or helped you previously.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So thank you so much to both of you, Jesse Draper, Jesse Forte, such a valuable conversation. And for me, the big takeaway is, you know, we may be talking about a go-to-market strategy for a brand, which sounds really dry and boring, but this is really about people. It's about telling your personal story and connecting with other people who are going to want to help not just your brand, but you. So when you go out to market, it is you going out to market.